Hello everyone, I am Mrs. Sunita Dor. Topic covered here is operator precedence passing precedence function. In previous video, we consider operator precedence grammar, which is a kind of shift reduced passing method. In this video, we are going to consider how to handle the unary operator and precedence function. Learning outcomes: at the end of the session, students will be able to handle the unary operator and find the precedence function for given operator precedence relation. Let logical negation to be a unary prefix operator which is not binary, then with the help of the operator precedence relation we make theta yield precedence to logical negation for any operator theta whether it is unary or binary. Logical negation takes precedence over theta if logical negation has higher precedence than theta. Logical negation yield precedence to theta if logical negation has lower precedence than theta. Example, if logical negation has higher precedence than ampersand and ampersand is left associative, then group the expression E ampersand logical negation E ampersand E as left parenthesis E ampersand left parenthesis logical negation E, complete both the parenthesis ampersand E by above rule. Operator precedence passing cannot handle the minus sign, that is both unary prefix and binary prefix. Suppose if we give unary and binary minus the same precedence, then we will fail to pass the string like id into minus id correctly. The best approach to solve this problem, let the lexical analyzer handle this problem. The lexical analyzer will return two different tokens for the unary minus and the binary minus. The lexical analyzer will need a look ahead to distinguish the binary minus from the unary minus. Compilers using the operator precedence parser need not store the table of precedence relation. The table can be encoded by the two precedence functions f and g that map terminal symbols to integer. We attain the function f and g for the symbol a and b. F of a less than g of b whenever a yield precedence to b. F of a is equal to g of b whenever a has the same precedence as b, and f of a greater than g of b whenever a takes precedence over b. Consider algorithm constructing precedence function. Input and operator precedence matrix. Output precedence function representing the input matrix or an indication that none exist. Method step 1, create symbol FA and GA for each A that is a terminal or dollar. Step 2, partition the created symbols into as many group as possible in such a way that if A has the same precedence as B, then FA and GB are in the same group. We may have to put the symbols in the same group even if they are not related by has the same precedence as relation. For example, if A has the same precedence as B and C has the same precedence as B, then FA and FC must be in the same group since they are both in the same group as GB. Step 3, create a directed graph whose nodes are in the groups. For each symbol, if A yield precedence to B, then place an edge from the group of GB to the group of FA. If A takes precedence over B, then place an edge from the group of FA to that of the GB. An edge or the path from FA to GB means FA must exceed G of B. A path from GB to FA means G of B must exceed F of A. Step 4. If the constructed graph has a cycle, then no precedence function exists. When there are no cycles, then collect the length of longest path from the group of FA and GB respectively. Consider the example E derives E plus E, E into E or ID and the operator precedence relation table. Consider the nodes for the function F and G of every symbol ID plus multiplication and dollar. Consider first row of the operator precedence relation table. There is no relation between FID and GID, hence there will be no arc between FID and GID. The relation between FID and G plus is take precedence over, so there will be an arc from the FID to G plus. The relation between FID and G star is take precedence over, so there will be an arc from FID to G star. The relation between FID and the G dollar is take precedence over, so there will be an arc from FID to G dollar. Now consider the second row of the operator precedence table. The relation between F plus and the GID is yield precedence 2, so there will be an arc from GID to F plus. The relation between F plus and the G plus is take precedence over, so there will be an arc from F plus to G plus. The relation between F plus and G star is yield precedence 2, so there will be an arc from G star to F plus. The relation between F plus and G dollar is take precedence over, so there will be an arc from the F plus to G dollar. Now consider the third row in operator precedence relation table. The relation between F star and GID is yield precedence 2, so there will be an arc from the GID to F star. The relation between F star and G plus is take precedence over, so there will be an arc from the F star to G plus. The relation between F star and G star is take precedence over, so there will be an arc from the F star to G star. The relation between F star and the G dollar is take precedence over, so there will be an arc from the F star to G dollar. Consider the fourth row in the operator precedence relation table. The relation between F dollar and GID is yield precedence 2, so there will be an arc from GID to F dollar. The relation between F dollar and G plus is yield precedence 2, so there will be an arc from the G plus to F dollar. The relation between F dollar and G star is yield precedence 2, so there will be an arc from the G star to F dollar. There is no relation between F dollar and G dollar, hence no arc will be there between F dollar and the G dollar. Now consider how to obtain the entries in the matrix. The length of the longest path from FID to F dollar is shown here. So the entry for F on ID in the matrix is 4. The length of the longest path from the GID to F dollar is from GID to F star, from F star to G star, from G star to F plus, from F plus to G plus, and from G plus to F dollar. So the entry for G on ID in the matrix is 5. The length of the longest path from the F plus to F dollar is shown on this slide. So the entry for G on ID in the matrix is 2. The length of the longest path from the G plus to F dollar is from G plus to F dollar. Hence the entry for G on ID in the matrix is 1. The length of the longest path from F star to F dollar is given in the figure on the slide. Therefore, the entry for G on ID in the matrix is 4. The length of the longest path from G star to F dollar is from G star to F plus, from F plus to G plus, and from G plus to F dollar. So here the entry for G on ID is 3. As there is no relation between F dollar and G dollar, hence the entry for F on dollar in the matrix is 0. Also, the entry for G on the dollar in the matrix is 0. Till now, we consider how to handle unary operator and constructing the constructing precedence function algorithm. Now pause this video and reflect on this question for a minute or 2 minutes and write your response. Once you return the answer to this question, then you can restart playing this video. The question is, find the precedence function for the following operator precedence relation. I hope all of you have completed this activity. Consider the node for the function f and g of every symbol id plus star and the dollar. Now, the first row in the operator precedence relation table, and according to the entry in each cell, enter the arc in the graph. Similarly, second row, third row, fourth row. Also, the entries in the matrix are given on the slide. This is the reference used for preparing this presentation. Thank you.